Hello there, welcome to this video. We'll review everything you need to know to start straight away with Steinberg Cubase 9. Leave comments and suggestions in the video description to improve our future video guides. Cubase 9 is a DAW, Digital Audio Workstation, a professional software used to produce, record, and edit your own music tracks by using real instruments or digital synthesizers or synths. In this video, we will have a look at the very basic features, but consider that you may need further guides and practice to go professional and advanced. When you open Cubase 9, the Steinberg Hub opens, showing several ready templates to use. To learn how to use this software, let's start with a new project by going to Create Empty below. The Cubase workspace opens, divided in several parts: the Inspector panel on the left, other important panels on the right, the main player at the bottom, and the main Cubase project in the center. A Cubase project is the heart of your work. This is composed by several tracks called channels, and each of these can contain several objects called events placed in different instances of time, creating your overall audio output. Let's start with the basic audio files called samples. These are rendered audio files ready to use that can be played directly. You can import audio samples by clicking and dragging these on your workspace. These are shown as audio events contained inside a new track called Audio Track. If you need more audio tracks, just click on the plus button on top. The audio event is shown with its audio waveform and is placed somewhere on the project timeline above, measured in beats and bars, which is the standard measurement unit used in audio production. If you prefer using seconds, right-click on the timeline and choose seconds. Then zoom in and out by holding Control down and using your mouse wheel. Any event can be fully edited as you like. Click and drag it to move it in time. This snaps to each bar or beat, depending on what you choose as grid type above. To disable snappings, just move while holding Control down. Also, if you hover on an event, you can use several nodes. Pull the top one to regulate the event volume. Use the triangular ones on the left and right to add volume fades. Use the left and right nodes at the bottom to stretch or shorten the event duration, and use the right node in the middle to loop the clip as much as you like. Also, when you click on an event, you will select it, and this will become darker. At this point, you can use Ctrl and X to cut or delete the event, Ctrl and C to copy it, and Ctrl and V to paste it. Cubase has other editing tools useful to work with your events. You can find them at the very top or by holding your right click. For example, you can use the range selection to draw a rectangular area that selects multiple events within it. Use the split tool to split an event in two, or the draw tool to create new empty events inside a track. If you make a mistake, remember to use Ctrl and Z to fast undo. At the bottom, you have the main player to play back your project content. This plays exactly what is under the vertical pointer that can be fixed by clicking on the timeline above. Also, you can loop continuously a piece of your project by enabling the transport cycle button, very useful especially while trying modifications on a channel or on an event. If you hover over the top edge of the timeline, your pointer becomes a small pencil. If you click and drag, you will create a violet cycle region that selects a part of the project so that when you enable the transport cycle button, you will repeatedly play the selected area where the vertical pointer enters. If you create an inverted cycle region, this will be colored in orange, indicating the part of the project that must not be played when transport cycle is enabled. Through the player, you can also fix the tempo, measured in beats per minute, that regulates the playback speed of your project. You can click and drag from it to regulate it, or double-click on it to type it directly. Let's see how to edit audio events and channels. When you double-click on an event, the editor panel opens at the bottom, with other panels we will review later. This panel shows the overall event audio form in detail that you can zoom in and out by holding Control down and using your mouse wheel. To play its content, you can't use the main player since this always references the main project. Here, you can either use the Play or the Scrub tool. With the Play tool, you can play a part of the event waveform by clicking on it and holding it down. With the Scrub tool, you have to click and drag on the left or right. Additionally, you can draw and personalize the audio waveform by using the Draw tool. If you do not need these panels anymore, you can close them by using the cross button. Also, you can personalize your channels to change the audio output of their events. On the far left, you have several useful buttons for your channel audio. Use the M button to mute all its events inside, or the S solo button to disable all the other channels except the interested one. You can also rename the channel by double-clicking on its name. Additionally, if you click on Edit Channel Settings, you will open a panel that can be used to adjust the channel audio properties, add adjustments and effects. On the extreme right, you have the basic channel volume properties, such as the dB, decibel meter, used to monitor and adjust the overall channel volume, and the balance panner on top, used to distribute the volume between the left and the right stereo channels correctly. On top, you can fix the device properties to use import audio under stereo in or export audio under stereo out. On the left, you have two panels, the strip to add adjustments to the channel and the inserts to add effects. The strip panel lists several features to check or enhance the channel audio. By default, the EQ position is enabled, showing the frequency spectrum of the channel output in real time. You can click on Gate to add a noise gate to reduce noise, on Comp to add audio compression, or on Limit to add limiters. We won't see these adjustments in this basic tutorial. Each of these adjustments and corrections are shown under Channel Strip, where you can directly check and correct all strips through their knobs. On the left, you can enable or disable each strip by using the Bypass Module button or change the strip preset to use by using Select Preset. Next to the strips, you have the inserts, which are special audio effects that may change the final channel sound. Click on one slot and browse for your favorite effect to add it. Then, use its own interface to fix the effect properties. As seen for the strips, use Bypass Insert to disable or enable the effect, or the Select Insert button to switch the effect with another. Use the E button to open the effect interface to adjust it. By default, these effects are applied after the strip corrections, but you can choose to apply insert effects first by using the button close to strip. Through the Channel Settings panel, you can apply several audio filters on your channel, acting on the lowest, mid, or the highest audio frequencies from left to right. You can use the knobs at the bottom, or click on the equalizer directly. Close the panel when you finish editing. The inspector panel on the left summarizes the main modifications applied on the selected channel. This is all that Cubase is able to do with audio samples. However, it has several interesting features to work with MIDI events, which are used to compose your own music from scratch by defining notes and instruments to use. As instruments, you can use an external one by connecting it with Cubase or a digital synthesizer. In this basic video, we will see how to work with synths only. On the extreme right, inside the VST Instruments panel, click on Add Track Instrument to start composing. Choose the right synth to use under Instrument and then go to Add Track. This opens the synth interface and creates a new empty track called Instrument Track. So, enable the Draw tool and click and drag on the track to create a new empty MIDI event. Then, enable the Object Selection tool and double-click on the event to open the editor panel below. Keeping in mind the editor is dedicated to the samples, the MIDI editor panel opens a piano roll with several notes on the left. With the Draw tool above, you can drop the notes to use and define their length in time. To remove notes, use the Erase tool instead. The easiest way to compose a MIDI event is to loop playback its region by using the cycle region and the transport cycle enabled. For each single note, you can edit several properties, such as volume as velocity, the pitch as pitch bend, and so on by using the same draw tool. All of these are collected right below the piano roll. The instrument track created is able to collect just MIDI events inside, and all its own MIDI events will use the same synth chosen as an instrument to give sound to their notes. For this reason, these tracks can't welcome samples that already had a rendered sound waveform. The way to edit and manage the instrument tracks is equal to what we have seen for audio tracks, including strips and inserts. You just have an additional button called Edit Instrument, which is used to regulate the synth audio to use. Another amazing feature is the Sampler Control Panel. This is used to compose MIDI events that use an audio sample as an instrument. Through the plus button, add a new sampler track. This opens the sampler control automatically. Then, just drag and drop a sample event from an audio track or an audio file from your computer, and its sound waveform will be shown completely. This may be looped by using loop mode, but to make things easier, let's just choose the no loop option. At the bottom, regulate the sample pitch with the coarse, fine, and glide knobs, and the sample volume with the volume and the pan knobs on the right. At the bottom, you have a piano roll that you can extend by moving its marker if you need. By clicking on the piano, you will play the sample with different notes. Finally, enable the record button and click on the piano roll to fix the notes to use on the MIDI event. This will use the same notes you have recorded and the imported sample as an instrument. Through the editor panel, correct and adjust its notes. Consider that just such notes are recorded, even if other channels are played. Since the Record Enable button is on just the sampler track. If you don't like the sample file used for the sampler track MIDI, you can change it by selecting the sampler track, open the sampler controller, and dropping another audio file on it. When your project has multiple tracks, it can be useful to balance their volume by using the Mix Console. Check it out. Let's now see how to quickly and save and render your project. If you need to save it to edit and adjust it in the future, just go to File and then to Save As. If you want to extract the final audio, you have to render it. Select with the violet cycle region the part of your project to render. Make sure that there are no record or monitor buttons enabled on the select channel, and mute all the channels that you don't want to render. Then go to File, Export, Audio Mixdown. Select Name, Destination Path, and Audio Format under File Format. Check all the audio settings at the bottom, and then go to Export. If the render does not work, check carefully your ASIO drivers used inside Cubase. Thanks for watching this video. Leave us feedback to improve our future guides for this amazing software.